Hey everyone, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. You might have heard of data science. Data science and artificial intelligence have been a really big boon to the world of information technology because this entire world is one big data problem. And in this session, we're going to compare data science head-on with artificial intelligence and see where it stands. Well, before we begin with the session, make sure to subscribe to the Intellipaat's YouTube channel and hit that bell icon so that you never miss an update from us. Here's the agenda for today. We'll begin by taking a quick introduction to data science, followed by which we can check out where data science is actually used. And after this, we can check out what artificial intelligence is and some facts about artificial intelligence at the same time. And after this, we're going to compare data science head on with artificial intelligence. And guys, if you have any queries, make sure to head down to the comment section below and do let us know, and we'll be happy to help out at the earliest. And guys, if you're interested in doing an end-to-end course certification in data science, Intellipaat provides the Data Science Architect Master's program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate at the same time. Well, without further ado, let's begin the class. Coming to the first item on the agenda, it is introduction to artificial intelligence. I am sure in the past decade, and in fact in this decade, we've been hearing a lot about artificial intelligence, right? So what is artificial intelligence? It is very simple, guys. It is a theory and the development of computer systems to basically mimic human intelligence, or we can even state it as a machine performing a task which would actually require some sort of human intervention there. Well, there are many tasks where artificial intelligence at this point of time is actually a lot better than human beings. For example, we have image recognition, we have speech recognition, process of decision making, and translations. When you think about all four of these, basically, you will know that there is some sort of human intervention required because we are trained to look at images, we understand speech, and our brain is logical enough to perform very good decision making and decision taking steps. But then when we talk about translations as well, pretty much we have been trained to understand two different languages where we can translate between one to the other as well. But nowadays all this can be done faster, more efficiently, and eventually better than human beings by making use of machines, guys. So where are we with artificial intelligence today? Well, artificial intelligence has been so subtly integrated into our lives we don't even notice it is there anymore, guys. Why do we say this? Stick with me for the next couple of slides and you will understand just this. Because when you look around you, there is artificial intelligence everywhere. And also you might have heard of the terms such as artificial intelligence is the best career path of this decade and whatnot. And that is a heavy statement because we are just at the start of this decade, but then all the trends and all the analytics which have been performed, all the surveys which have been conducted, pretty much says that artificial intelligence as a career path and a technology is on the rise and it will be trending for the next 10 years. And as you can see, artificial intelligence has the biggest community ever. Well, if something is trending and if something is constantly on the number one spot for the last couple of years, then definitely it attracts the attention of everyone, right? So that's basically that. And then guys, coming to where artificial intelligence has been used in this world, well, this is why I told you it has been very subtly integrated into our lives. Everything from Google Assistant, Cortana, there's Siri, there's Bixby, there's Alexa, and much more. So you can talk to your phones, you can talk to your computers, you can talk to your machines to get so much done. In fact, there are smart homes being implemented for the last couple of years. Well, all you have to do is ask Alexa to do stuff for you. Alexa can unlock the door for you. Alexa can turn on your TV, home theaters, and pretty much turn on the lights, move away the curtains, and pretty much everything. So when you think about it, it has been there around us for a while now. But then when we talk about the actual trending stuff about artificial intelligence, when we talk about revenues, especially for the next 5 years, you can see from the graph all the way from 2016 to 2025, the amount given is in million dollars. So, pretty much it was $357 million in 2016. Basically, this is the revenue generated by enterprise applications. From 357, it has been predicted that in 2025, it's going to hit $31,236 million, guys. So imagine the growth. As you can see on your screen, I am sure you guys can figure out that it is an exponential growth.
Just a quick info, in case you guys are looking for end-to-end course certification in data science, Intellipaat provides the Data Science Architect Master's program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same. The link is given in the description box, so make sure to check it out. And without further ado, let's get back to the class. And then when we talk about how much research is going on with respect to artificial intelligence, here is the thing. In the year 2000, there was less than around 1,000 technical papers which are actually published. But then when you talk about 2015 and up, there is skyrocket. And from, in fact, from 15 all the way till 25, the numbers just keep going as high up as you can think, guys. So we started all the way from 1,500. In 2015, it hit somewhere around 18,000. And now, you know, pretty much, it is way more than 40,000 papers which have been published, guys. So it is 9 times growing every single year is what we can tell. And then coming to this slide where we're trying to see where artificial intelligence fits in. Well, there are a couple of steps when we talk about data, you know, steps such as data generation, data storage, data processing, and insight. So the first steps pretty much include data generation and data storage, and this gets covered altogether by the world of big data, guys. And then coming to data processing and actionable insights, well, artificial intelligence, here we go. Because when we talk about data processing, we can make use of machine learning, deep learning, neural networks, and there are many other concepts, guys, natural language processing, you know, support vector machines, and much more to pretty much process all of the data. And at the end of it, we have very good data analysis and analytics tools which make use of artificial intelligence to give us beautiful visualizations which can be used to derive actionable insight. And then finally, coming to the comparison between data science and artificial intelligence, on the first point we'll be discussing is the meaning. Well, guys, data science, as you can see, is a very detailed process which basically involves in, you know, pre-processing the data, performing some analysis on this data. At the end of the analysis comes the visualizations, where you'll be generating a lot of graphs, a lot of visuals, and at the end of it, you're going to use all of this to perform some predictions on some future trends, guys. But then coming to artificial intelligence is basically, you know, implementing a model. And what this model at the end of the day does is that, you know, it is used to forecast certain future trends, future events, what might happen, and how we can get there if that is the case. Well, coming to point number two, it's the skills. Well, when we talk about data science, again, data science, you have to understand this is an umbrella term for a lot of statistical techniques, a lot of design techniques, and development methodologies, guys. Well, when we talk about artificial intelligence, it has got a lot to do with algorithm design, algorithm development, efficiency conversions, and in fact, even deployment of all of these design and developed products, guys. But then coming to the next point, it is the technique. Here is where there is a lot of difference between artificial intelligence and data science. In data science, you know, we are actually majorly concerned about making use of data analysis and data analytics, guys. So data analysis, where we'll be using past data to analyze the present tense in a very simple term. And with respect to data analytics, we'll be using the past and the present data to predict the future trends, guys. That is why there is a small difference between analysis and analytics. But then when we talk about artificial intelligence, you need to know that, you know, we'll be concerned with a lot of machine learning concepts in this particular stage. It can be machine learning, it can be a lot of concepts such as deep learning, neural networks, and much more, as I just mentioned in the couple of slides ago. Well, basically coming to the next point, it is the knowledge. Well, when we talk about data science was actually established, you know, to find hidden patterns and hidden trends in data, to make more sense of the data and to make it a more friendlier entity. But then when we talk about artificial intelligence, you need to know that, you know, with respect to artificial intelligence, it is to make sure whatever data we are dealing with can be autonomously handled. So we are trying to remove the human from the picture when we talk about artificial intelligence, to give the machine some depth, some understanding of the data, to let it work on its own without the human dependency, guys. Then coming to the next point quickly is processing. With respect to processing, again, data science does not involve a very high degree of scientific processing. It involves a lot of complex procedures, yes, but then all of these are not to the highest standards of scientific processing, guys. But then when we talk about artificial intelligence, even as the name suggests, it can be a bit more complex when we talk about artificial intelligence, guys, because here we'll be having a lot of high level processing, a lot of complex processing to deal with, because at the end of the day, we're trying to implement some sort of autonomy in the machines, you know, which eventually are telling the machines that they need to step up their game and to mimic the human brain. And the human brain in today's world is the most intelligent being there is, right? So Coming to the next one is the goal of these technologies. Well, with respect to data science, complex models, you know, are basically built by making use of various insights, various facts about the data, it's a lot of statistical techniques, modeling and whatnot. But then when we talk about artificial intelligence, well, artificial intelligence was meant to build models that emulate cognition, guys. By emulate cognition, what we basically mean is that, again, we're trying to make the machine self-sustained enough so that where it would not require certain human dependencies. And the next thing is that it will require some sort of human understanding to a certain level, because that is what is required to achieve some sort of cognition. And then coming to the salary of the developers, well, the average salary of a data scientist is around $130,000 per year, and the average salary of an artificial intelligence developer is around $120,000 per year. Guys, this is the average amount that I've mentioned to keep it to the scope of all the viewers. Well, guys, what you need to understand at this point of time is that we have kept the average number on the screen. You can pretty much have access to 3 to 4 times the salaries mentioned on your screen, regardless of which country you're working from or what company you're working for as well, guys. So you have to know that these both career paths are very fun to work with, very lucrative, and at the end of the day, you will have a lot of fun at your job at the same time. So to summarize the differences between these two, basically, I want to say that artificial intelligence, you know, makes use of these loops of perspective that we call, and then pretty much we use some sort of planning to become intelligent in how we handle data, guys. But then when we talk about data science is all about using patterns, all about using trends, and pretty much, you know, getting at a decision faster, more efficient, which might have crossed the eye when we talk about data. So coming to when we should go about using data science or artificial intelligence, well, data science is actually preferred when you need to understand and find out patterns and trends in the data. It is used if you have some sort of a mathematical requirement where you need an in-depth and faster analysis of the same. It is also used when you need to perform EDA. EDA is basically exploratory data analysis, where you'll be hunting and pretty much going through the data to find something which might skip the naked eye, as we say. And then you'll also be using it if you need some sort of improvement, which is supposed to be linear, which you need a constant growth in your particular concepts, and also it'll be required if you require very fast mathematical processing, guys. But then the last requirement is that, you know, there are a lot of industry requirements which will involve a lot to do with prediction. For example, if you're a sales company, a product company, you'll be concerned with what is the products you might sell next month, next year, the next decade, and so, right? So predictive analytics also helps here, and data science does just that. Coming to artificial intelligence, well, artificial intelligence is a requirement if you know, you require some sort of precision which is out of this world, guys. And I mean it when I say that, because AI is made to use in full potentials, in full swing, when we're basically trying to get the greatest degree of precision that we can. And then when we talk about decision making as well, artificial intelligence is known to be faster when we compare directly to humans in many aspects. So that is that. And then coming to logical decision handling, again, guys, as humans, there might be emotional interference in multiple tasks where the requirement does not call for that. In that case, pretty much artificial intelligence will not have any swing to any emotions, and it'll work fine. And then handling repetitive tasks for humans can be a bit of a challenge, but then when we talk about AI, pretty much it can handle it with ease, guys. Again, working 24/7, 365 days without any breaks, performing very good risk analysis, risk taking abilities, and making sure you're efficient through all of these points that are mentioned on your screen, AI does it better than humans at this point of time. And then there are many other points with respect to data science and artificial intelligence as well, guys. Well, to keep it to the scope of all the viewers of this particular video, we had to simplify it to present it here, guys. Now, coming to the companies which make use of data science and artificial intelligence, well, we have everyone from Apple, Google, Amazon, Twitter, Facebook, Nvidia, and thousands of other companies who make use of data science on a daily basis. Then coming to the companies which make use of artificial intelligence, we have everyone from Walmart Labs, Microsoft, Genpact, Accenture, Ericsson, KPMG, and all the Fortune 500 companies that you can ever think of, guys. So in today's world where we live, data is an unruly entity, and we already know that. But worry not, concepts such as data science and artificial intelligence are in full swing to make data, to make all of these processes a friendlier entity, and to help us work with it faster, more efficiently, and with better outcomes and results. Just a quick info, in case you guys are looking for end-to-end course certification in data science, Intellipaat provides the Data Science Architect Master's program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same. The link is given in the description box, so make sure to check it out. I hope this session was very informative for you all. If you have any more points you want to add on this data science versus artificial intelligence video, or if you have any queries in general, make sure to head down to the comment section and do let us know. We'll be happy to help out at the earliest. And on that note, have a nice day.